There's no better way than to take something really simple and show you how you would derive it using Huffman tree techniques. I'm going to construct a tree from the probabilities, and I'm going to go up, and I'll hope I don't run out of space. All these probabilities add up to one. Order them starting with the highest at the left and the lowest at the right. You can do it the other way around if you like, as long as you're consistent about it. Now, there's no problem here because they're all a quarter. They're ordered already. The Huffman algorithm then says group in twos from the right successively. And by going through this, I hope it'll be clear what I mean. Starting at the right, take the lowest two probabilities that you can see. So I group these together as the branches of a tree. Computer scientists always draw their trees, nearly always, upside down. The leaves, if you like, the base of the tree is down here, but the actual root, where it springs from, is up at the top. If you group a quarter and a quarter together, that gives a combined probability of a half at that node. These two probabilities have been coped with in some sense. You're now left at a three probability situation. Take the lowest two probabilities you can see. If there's any ambiguity about which you should choose, then choose the rightmost set of probabilities. Well, here there's no problem. So the next stage for the two lowest probabilities is to group those together and make a one half there. Combined probability, they're done. The next stage, so this is almost going like recursively back up the tree, is to say, but we now group these together, the half and the half. We've now reassured ourselves that all the probabilities here, when grouped together and added up, come to 1.0, and we'd be in deep trouble if they didn't. That is your Huffman tree with those probabilities. The next thing you do, this is great fun, is to decorate the tree. I now want to, from this, work out what the correct code, the minimal code, should be for a given state. Starting at the root of the tree, I always annotate the left going branch with a 0 and the right going branch with a 1. You can do it the other way around, uniformly throughout, if you want to. It will come to a slightly different looking Huffman code, but it will have just the same properties as the one I'm going to derive. When you come to this node and you say, I'm now going to descend to the left again, the rule is you add a 0 to what you've already got. So you end up with 0, 0. How about this state? You come down on a 0, but then you go to the right. Every time you go to the right, you add a 1 to what you've already got. We've already got a 0, add a 1. And here we are, look, it works for the rest. Go down to the right with a 1, then go down to the left. Every time you go down to the left, add a 0. To what you've got. There we are. 1, down to the right, add a 1, that's that one. So there we are. What Huffman basically said in 1952 when he did this was that this was the method of getting a compact code. In other words, the best you could possibly do for those probabilities. And I think David Huffman's thesis is famous for only being about 12 pages long. I think many of us would love to write a thesis saying, here is an unsolved problem, I've done it, please give me a PhD. Yes, it's only 12 pages long. But to be fair to those who are examining him, it's easy enough to prove that it works for something like this, which is so easy because they are all exact negative powers of 2. The harder thing is to prove that it still gives the best possible compromise, even when the probabilities don't work in your favour. I have to sort of sound a word of warning here. Let me do the San Francisco entropy on the San Francisco page, if I can find space to squeeze it in. If you remember, the entropy is the sum over all the weather states. So you typically see in textbooks things looking like this. From the first weather to the fourth weather situation, take the sum over pi log to the base 2, 1 over pi. That, of course, comes down to being the sum over minus pi log pi is equally valid. So what we do for the entropy is we take the weighted sum of the probability of the state happening times the log of the probability of it happening. And we've discovered in the entropy and compression video, the entropy overall is 2 bits. Of course it is. It's exact powers of 2. All the weather states are the same. But then we worked out the average length of the code, and the average length of the code is 2 bits. Yeah, they all occur with probability of 1/4, but they're all 2 bits long. So the average length of the message you set is also 2 bits. This is so simple and so straightforward that the efficiency, which is measured as H over L, in this particular case is 2/2. 2 bits for entropy, 2 bits for the average length, which is equal to 100%. You can hit the entropy limit with this weather system encoded in this way, because these probabilities are all negative powers of 2. For those of you who've encountered entropy in physics or chemistry, take great care. Information theorists call entropy H. Don't do that in your chemistry exam. In chemistry, H is reserved for the amount of heat in a system. And certainly remembering back to my chemistry days, I think they use the symbol S for entropy. So don't get confused. Shannon used H for entropy, so I will. What about if we have weather states or some system where these probabilities are not exact powers of 2? We'll look at a fishing trip. Let's say that we want a system with probabilities of 1/3, 1/3, 1/9, 1/9, 1/9. This person with a pretty good set of fishing kits and a good selection of fish to catch actually at the end of the day ends up that 1/3 of his or her catch is cod, another 1/3 is sea bass, 1/9 proportion of the catch is tuna, 1/9 is baby shark, and we got a bit stuck for inspiration here, barracuda. Whether you could get them all from the same boat, I don't know. But let's say this person wants to transmit back in the shortest possible code what the predominant catch is that he's got. So he wants to signal whether it's, you know, he's got a good lot of cod today, or is it bass, or is it whatever. First thing always is check your probabilities add up. That is up to 3/3, which is 1. Here we go, Huffman tree. We're still going to use log to the base 2. From the right, take the pair of lowest probabilities you can see, and those are these 1/9. So that makes 2/9. Cross out the ones you've coped with. You've now got 1/3, 1/3, 1/9, 2/9. The two lowest probabilities you can still see are 2/9 and 1/9, which is going to combine to make a 1/3. Next stage, the two lowest probabilities you can see, well, you've got 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. We've coped with that, we've coped with that. If you get a choice of either that pair or that pair of thirds, it doesn't matter which, actually. You'll get slightly different codes, but with similar properties. 1/3 and this 1/3 gets combined into 2/3. And the final stage, you can all see, is dead easy. We triumphantly find that we do add up to a total probability of 1.0. Now comes the fun bit of writing down the Huffman codes for this in binary. You're descending left, so that's a 0. You're going right, so that's a 1. You come down on this one, so that's a 1 and then a 0. This arm gets 1, 1, but then you come down here, that's going to be 1, 1, 0. Therefore, this arm coming down here is 1, 1, 1. This one is 1, 1, 0, and that one is 1, 1, 1. So those are your Huffman codes. When you take H as the sum of your, this is now from state number 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. State number 1 is I've caught cod. State number 2 is I've caught bass. Up to 5 of your minus pi log to the base 2 of pi, you are going to find, to your dismay, that the entropy comes out to being 2.113 bits. I've looked this up on my calculator. If any of you aren't sure how to take log to the base 2 of 1/3, then we must keep ganging up on Brady to do a number file on powers of number bases and logarithms. The average length, when you work it out, is 2.222 bits. So the efficiency is equal to one over the other, 2.113 over 2.222 is equal to 95.1% efficient. Not bad, not bad, but not nearly as good as the weather states. Why? Why is because these things are not exact negative powers of 2. With these things being exact negative powers of 3, I can confidently predict that if only we could calculate entropy in trits. So long as your properties of your line were such that errors were relatively infrequent,